It's about 7 a.m. This is Monday the 27th. Hiking down this old logging road at our farm. About 25 degrees this morning, 5 inches of fresh snow. Hopefully we can find some deer today. It's quiet, the snow is quiet. So we'll see. So I cut a bunch of deer tracks at this road intersection. I just stepped off into the rebrot on the upwind side of it. Hoping that something comes down this road. There's quite a few deer tracks on the road, so they're pretty fresh. They were feeding on all these briar patch sticker bushes last night. So sit here for 20 minutes or so. Six sets of deer tracks running up and down this road. Right here. All the way up behind me there. So we can focus. I can see about 100 yards that way and about 12 yards this way. So if something comes by, it'll be 4 or 5 yards. So my arrows are my natural and white fletched, which work really good for early season when it's green out. I can see the white, but since I don't have any arrows made up for winter, I brought some more of these zonkers. And so we're going to put some orange zonkers on the back of at least one or two of these arrows. Give them something I can see if I shoot them. Haven't yet, go check out the video on my natural luminox where I put these. It's a more in-depth video of putting these zonker strips on your arrows. So there we go. Got a little strip here. Some super glue. And we're just going to put a dab of super glue. To start it. Thank you. used to, but it should slow the arrow down. 20 yards I'm going to shoot, so. So he lifted another. In the morning, I'm gonna wake up and do some hunting. We've got about 6 inches of snow on the ground. It's dumping, so it's supposed to let up in the morning. It's gonna be an amazing day for blacktail. So I got my bow, I got my pack, arrows, broadheads, everything sharpened, except I forgot my finger tab. So got some scrap leather here. We're gonna make a quick finger tab. This isn't gonna be anything fancy, neither are my other ones, so I'm not going to be missing out on anything, but let's get started here. So I kind of know the basic shape. I'm just going to go off my three fingers to give me my width, and then I'll give myself basically a big D shaped, and then we'll trim it to fit, and then I'll put some paracord on it to hold it on my finger. There we go. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this longer than I need, and then I'm going to fold it over, and that'll give me a straight line for when I put my tab on my string. I kind of have a reference point. Scissors here. These are not leather scissors. So kind of get an idea if that's folded over in my fingers. We're just gonna use some of this red cotton string. It might be nylon. I don't know. It's not good thread, but it'll work for the day. So we got it stitched around the whole outside there. So we're going to go ahead and get that stitched up. Alright, so that should work. It's hideous, but it's gonna work. Stitching's tore out a couple spots. This is not the leather that I would normally use, but it'll make a good finger tab. A little bit soft, but it's thin, so it shouldn't affect my air flight too much. Hopefully I get some close shots. So, we got all the stitching tied up. Next step is gonna be to punch two holes in here, and then we'll get a piece of paracord threaded through there. Let's get going. Get these trimmed. Let's go ahead and burn the ends. What can we strike these on? Strike anywhere matches. Melt that knot over. Nice. There you go. Not bad for 10 minutes, 10 o'clock at night, the night before you go out hunting. I just came out of that reprod. Got a fresh set of coyote tracks in the road here, so we'll see. Ended up seeing those four deer. I tried to cut them off. They weren't running hard, but no catching them. They knew I was there. So we're gonna loop back around and drop back down a couple hundred yards from where we came up. That's where all the deer tracks were going, so we're gonna give that a shot. Base of that. That's pretty cool. It's a little after 10 o'clock. I haven't seen anything in quite a while. tracks are kind of dried up as I'm dropping down the hill here. Definitely think they're more on the east side of the farm, so the deer anyway. So we're gonna head back to the truck, see if we can't cut some tracks, some fresher tracks, and follow those around for a little bit. It's nice and quiet up here. Jump back on that trail that I walked out earlier. See if I can't get closer. All right, those deer are up here. Got good wind. I'm under 75 yards now. Shortly after this, my battery actually died. I hunted this group of deer all the way till dark and never caught up with them. Success to me isn't always a notch tag, but a wonderful day in God's creation. I hope everybody enjoyed, and we'll see you next time.